الحمد لله الذي لا يرجى لكشف الشدائد إلا هو ولا يدعى لدفع المصائب إلا هو وما طلب الواصلين في الكونين إلا هو وما مراد العاشقين إلا هو الناس كلهم فقراء ولا غني إلا هو الناس كلهم فقراء الناس كلهم ضعفاء ولا قوي إلا هو لا خالق ولا مالك ولا ناصر إلا هو هل من خالق غير الله يرزقكم من السماء والأرض لا إله إلا هو وموسى على الطور حين ناداه قال لا إله إلا هو ويوسف في البئر حين ناداه قال لا إله إلا هو وإبراهيم في النار حين ناداه قال لا إله إلا هو ويونس في بطن الحوت حين ناداه قال لا إله إلا هو ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله وخليله وسفيهه صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأهل بيته وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد ومن الناس من يشتري لهو الحديث ليضل عن سبيل الله بغير علم ويتخذها هزوا أولئك لهم عذاب مهين. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ليكونن من أمتي أقوام يستحلون الحر والحرير والخمر والمعازف أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انك انت العليم الحكيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Respected listeners, first of all, I'd like to thank the brothers that had given me this mashwara to talk about this topic of music. I mean, it's become so widespread that a few of my friends, colleagues, they got together and we had a small discussion regarding something to talk about. And the thing that kept cropping up was the topic of music. And the simple reason to it is, if we look around us, you'll see many brothers and sisters sitting at home with the family in front of the television. You'll see many brothers and sisters sitting in front of the laptops. You'll see many of our children and sons sitting in front of their computers. Brothers and sisters walking about in the town centers. You'll see that they're all entranced by the sound of music and totally oblivious to their surroundings. Allahu Akbar, you know, you'll hear people complaining about the pollution cars have caused. That the cars that we have today, they've caused a lot of pollution. But very few people realize the pollution caused by the car stereos. You know, we'll have brothers and sisters complaining regarding the pollution that has been caused by heavy machinery. But few of us come to realize the pollution caused by heavy car systems, heavy speaker systems in nightclubs, in shopping centers. Every shop you walk into, you'll hear the sound of music. Very, very few people realize this. And again, the simple reason to this is because we are surrounded like an octopus by this music. Wherever you go, whichever shop you walk into, whichever road you are walking down, whoever you are with, you will be hearing the sound of music. Whether you go into a shoe shop, you will hear music. Whether you go into a shop selling sofas, you will hear music. Whether you walk into a shop that is selling dishes, you will hear Indian music. Wherever you go, you will hear music. It's become such a norm that no longer does it remain harmful, no longer does it remain a sin. The sound of music, it may have an embrace, it may sound soothing or very, very exciting, but wallahi, the damage and the harm that this music causes, we don't realize. The effect that is having on our society, the effect is having on our mentality, the effect is having on our younger children, and most important, the effect is having on our soul and our spiritual state. If we look around us, we will see the staggering amounts of money that is being spent, the staggering amounts of time that is being spent just in pursuing this interest. Inshallah, through the course of the bayan, we'll be looking at how much fun it is to be involved in such a sin and something that invites the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But just before that, I want to look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have got to say about this topic of music. What does Islam say about music? What is Islam's view on music? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first Quran ayat I want to mention is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says it in the Quran, قُلْ هُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَأَكُمْ وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبَصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ. Allah is telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, قُلْ هُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَأَكُمْ, that He, Allah, is the one who originated you, Allah is the one who created you. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبَصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ, and He is the one who created for you and made for you ears, eyes, and aha. But then look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says towards the end of the ayah, قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ, that how little do you show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the Quran ayah, we can understand that this hearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, because we have to remember that the enjoyment of music, it all depends on this faculty of hearing and this blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is reminding us that this is a blessing given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ, from this Allah is indicating that it is something that you are supposed to show gratitude towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. If we look, this same faculty of hearing, this blessing, ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if it is used properly, it can be used to our advantage. And if it is used improperly, it can be used to our destruction. Through this same faculty of hearing, this ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a person, he can gain guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can gain the nur, the light of hidayah, through which he can reach Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which will assure him eternal success. And through this same faculty of hearing that Allah has given us, a person, he can misuse it and abuse it to such an extent that it could lead him to his own destruction, i.e. the fire of Jahannam. He could spend his whole life, he could be eternally punished just for misusing and abusing this faculty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran gives an example of both type of people. Those people who misuse this hearing and therefore they threw themselves into destruction, into eternal destruction. And then Allah gives an example of those people who used this and they took full benefit, they took full advantage of this hearing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them, therefore which assured them eternal success in the gardens of paradise. To begin with, those people who misused this hearing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, He says about them, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ, that those people who disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would be recited, they would say, لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ, do not listen to this Quran, وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ, and make noise, i.e. make noise when it is being recited, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ, so that you may overpower it. The mushrikeen, they would make noise when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would recite The ayat of Quran, the verses of Quran, the mushrikeen, the polytheists of Makkah and the kuffar, what they would do is they would make noise. So the other people around Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were not able to hear the verses being recited. Because they misused this hearing. Because they abused it and they didn't use it to his advantage. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he put them into the fire of Jahannam, which is eternal destruction. But if you look on the other hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises a certain group who used this ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to their advantage. Allah says, وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيدُ مِنَ الدَّمْعِ مِمَّا عَرَفُوا مِنَ الْحَقِّ. That a group of people, they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Najran. And these people, they were Christians. They came only just to listen to what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has got to say. And it was their job to go back and inform their leaders. But what had happened when they heard what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited, they began crying. Their eyes overflowed with the tears, they began crying because of the truth that they had realized. وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا, and when they heard, Allah says, وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا, when they heard, مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ, which was revealed to the Prophet, تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيدُ مِنَ الدَّمْ, you would see their eyes overflow with tears, مِمَّا عَرَفُوا مِنَ الْحَقِّ, because of what they have realized of the truth. These people, they used their hearing. They came only to see what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to say about Allah. But because they used their hearing to their advantage, they used it properly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises these people only because of using their hearing. My brothers, again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, he mentions a quality of the mu'mineen, the believers, those people who believe in Allah and his Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah says, وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا اللَّغْوَ أَعْرَضُوا عَنْهُ, that when these people, they hear absurd talk, when the believers, when the mu'mineen, they hear absurd and filthy talk, أَعْرَضُوا عَنْهُ, they turn away from it. Allahu Akbar, look at the songs and the trucks that are being played in the cars today. Do they not have this absurd and filthy talk? Songs and trucks full of murdering each other, talking about sexual intercourse, talking about violence, thuggish attitudes, all this will come under absurd talk. Allah is saying that the mu'mineen, the believers, these people, they turn away. Allahu Akbar, if we look at our Muslims today, what do they do? They turn the stereo off. They turn the volume up, or they get the earpieces and they put them in even deeper so that they can hear it more clearly and more better. And if somebody begins to make noise and somebody begins to talk, what do they say? That please be quiet, let me listen. As in, let me listen to this filth and absurd talk that is being spoken. My brothers, look how far we are away from the description Allah has given us of a believer. Allah is saying that the believers, they turn away from this absurd and filth. And what do? We turn the volume on. Or we tell people to be quiet so that we can hear it more clearly. Or we get our earpieces and we put them deeper into our ears so that we can hear more clearly. Look at how far we are away from the description Allah gives of a believer in the Quran. وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا اللَّهُ وَأَعْرَضُوا عَنْهُ, that when they hear filth, they turn away. My brothers, what are we going to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyam? Just imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that, O Abdullah, stand. O Abdullah, you had seen that there were many people in front of you to whom I didn't give this blessing of hearing to. Nor had they ever heard the voice of their own mother, nor had they ever heard the voice of their own father. They had never heard the voice of anybody reading Quran. They had never heard the tilawat, the recitation of Quran. They had never heard a muazzin calling out for salah. They have never heard the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam being recited, read over and over again. O Abdullah, there were these people in front of you. There were those people that throughout their lives, I punished them by taking their hearing. Or I tested them to see how strong they were in faith by taking their hearing. Oh Abdullah, imagine how much they would have missed listening to the voice of their mother, their father, listening to the voice of Quran being recited, the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the muadhin calling out to salah. Oh Abdullah, from the day you were born until the day you are died, I have given you this blessing. How did you use this? How did you use it to your advantage? And how much gratitude did you show? What will we say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That, oh Allah, I used this blessing by listening to music. Oh Allah, you said in the Quran, وَإِذَا سَمِعُ اللَّهُ وَأَعْرَضُ عَنْهُ. But what I did, oh Allah, was I plugged it deeper into my ears. Oh Allah, I turned up the volume. Is this how we're going to reply back to Allah? Because each and every single limb that Allah has given us is going to be questioned about the how did you show gratitude for this limb. Allah says, إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْئُولًا. The verily, the hearing, the eyes, the heart, each and every single one is going to be questioned about. Nobody is going to run anywhere until these limbs are questioned about. The how did you show your gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Moving on to the first Quran ayat. Allah says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهُوَ الْحَدِيثِ لِيُضِلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَيَتَّخِذَهَا هُزُوًا أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. Allah says, of mankind there are those people who go out and buy discourses of distracting amusements so that they can mislead without knowledge, i.e. without knowledge of the consequences of their actions, so that they can mislead people away from the path of Allah, and so that they can make a mockery of the path of Allah. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. For these people, there is a disgraceful punishment. Imam Qurtubi rahmatullahi alayhi, he said that this is one of those verses from which the ulama, they have deduced the dislike and the impermissibility of music. Many other authorities of tafsir, they have also said that this is one of those ayat that the ulama, they say that from this ayat we can see the impermissibility and dislike of music in Islam. Imam Tabari rahmatullahi alayhi, he narrates many narrations. He narrates 2 from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, 8 from Abdullah ibn Abbas, 7 from Mufassir al-Mujahid, all saying that this verse, it refers to music. That those people who try to mislead others away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using music. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he would swear by Allah. He would say, I swear by the one that other than there is no God, that this verse, it refers to music. My brother, Allah, you know, it is our aim to stay focused in this dunya. If we look at the word in this ayat, love, this word, it means in Arabic anything that absorbs a person to such an extent that he forgets other things that are more important. Anything that is more important, he will forget, and he becomes so absorbed in this that he doesn't pay any attention. I.e. he is so absorbed in music that he forgets his salah. He is so absorbed in this music, he's so indulged in this music that his mother is calling him, his father is calling him, but he doesn't want to have anything to do with them. Why? Because he is listening to trucks. He is so absorbed that he is forgetting things of paramount importance. Everything has been forgotten and he is absorbed in this thing. Who can say that music doesn't absorb a person? Who can say that because of music we don't miss our salah? We don't neglect the rights of our mother and our father. We don't neglect the rights of our brothers and sisters and other Muslims out there because of this music. You see many children who are in their rooms, absorbed in this music. Their parents are shouting from downstairs. Their parents complain to the local alim that my son is like this, my daughter is like this. He is always watching the television. He is always on the laptop, listening to music. He's always got his earphones plugged in his ears, always listening to music. You will get so many ulama that get these complaints from parents regarding their children because they are so absorbed into this. It is our job to stay focused in this dunya on our akhirah. It is our job that we don't let such filth, disturbers and distract us away from this goal that we have of akhirat. My brothers, this is a temporary place that we are in. This dunya is temporary. One day everybody is going to die. One day everybody is going to go from this dunya. We cannot afford to be distracted from this dunya. The second verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَشْهَدُونَ الزُّورَ وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّغْوِ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا. Allah mentions in this ayah one or two attributes of again the mu'mineen, the believers. Allah says the believers are those people, وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَشْهَدُونَ الزُّورَ, that they do not witness zool. وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّغْوِ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا, and when they walk past lagwa, then they walk past in such a way, they walk past in an honorable way. They are not distracted by anything. You know, the Mufassirin, they say that this word zool, what does this word zool mean? It means gatherings of this same absurd talk, filth. Gatherings in where there is music and musical instruments. Gatherings which are disturbing a person from his akhirat and from his salah. Gatherings which disturb a person from things of paramount importance. This is what zool is. Love, again, fear anything, futile. When a person, he walks past these and he doesn't witness these, or if he walks past them and he doesn't pay any sort of attention, he walks past honorably, that person, he can feel that he is a mu'min. He can think to himself, he can assure himself that these are the qualities of a mu'min. Let me give you an example of this. A present day example of this will be that a brother is walking outside the masjid. He sees a group of brothers who are around a car, boo open, side doors open. There's bottles of alcohol being passed around. There's drugs being passed around and loud music switched on. This brother, he walks past and he doesn't pay any sort of attention. Despite being invited and called over, that, oh Abdullah, come over. Have a bit of a chill with us. But this person, he gives a salam and he walks on. This is a perfect example of this ayat, وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَشْهَدُونَ الزُّورَ وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّغْوِ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا. The third verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِكَ. This verse is one of the five verses in Surah Al-Isra, in the 15th sifara. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, here he describes the beginning of creation and what happened. It's a very famous story. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, and he instructed all the angels to prostrate before Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. But there was one, Iblis, who refused. Iblis said, أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِنُ خَلَقْتَهِ مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ تِينَ. I am much better than him. You create me from fire and you create him from wood. Shall I prostrate to him? Because of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he expelled him from Jannah. Now because Iblis has been expelled because of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, Iblis, he vows to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I was expelled due to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. All his progeny to come to the day of resurrection, until the day of Qiyamah, each and every single one of them, I am going to lead them astray because I was expelled from Jannah because of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to him, وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِ. Allah says to him, lead to destruction whoever you can. Now when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him this full permission that you can lead to destruction whoever you can, he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for respite until the day of Qiyamah. That give me life until the day of Qiyamah. This respite is granted to him. Then he asks for weapons. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even grants him the weapons. That take the weapons. Let's see what you can do. Let's see how many people you can lead astray from the path. Those people who are true to me, they will never ever leave the straight path. Now some of these weapons, one, An-Nisa Habailu Shaitan, that the women, they are traps of Shaitan. We see that through women.
So many men are led astray. So many men are led away from the straight path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the main weapon that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the ayah very, very clearly, Allah says, وَاسْتَغْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِسَوْتِكَ, that lead to destruction whoever you can بِسَوْتِكَ, with your voice. Now if a person thinks about it, he'll see that we can hear the voice of shaitan. So how can we be led astray? How can we be led to destruction through the voice of shaitan? If we ask the commentators, Hassan al-Bisri, Mujahid, if we ask these commentators, they will tell you that the voice of shaitan, what Allah is referring to here, is music. My brothers, look around us. How many people are led astray? How many people are led to breaking the laws of the country? How many people are led towards breaking the laws of deen through music? You will have heard of people who have gone out there and they have gone and killed someone. They have committed murder. Why? Only because of lyrics that they have heard in raps. People have gone and committed suicide. Why? Because of listening to some song which has led them and whispers, satanic whispers inside their head. Due to this, they have gone and committed suicide. They might have been stressed out. They might have been depressed. But whilst listening to a song, is caused such feelings inside him which has led him to go and commit suicide. Allahu Akbar. We hear of so much of this. These are all the whispers of shaitan. If these are not the whispers of shaitan, then what are they? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly said it. وَاسْتَغْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِكَ, that lead to destruction whoever you can with your voice. And if you ask the commentators again, they'll say that this bisawtik, it means music. After this, again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in another verse, أَفَمِنْ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ تَعْجَبُ وَتَضْحَكُونَ وَلَا تَبْكُونَ وَأَنْتُمْ صَامِدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these verses are the verses of Surah Al-Najm, which were revealed roughly in the fifth year of prophethood. 5 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had become a prophet, these verses were revealed. Now these verses in this surah, these verses, they contain basic Islamic beliefs, but in a very, very powerful and strong manner. At the same time, rebuking the mushrikeen for ridiculing the laws of Islam. What happened is, when this surah came down, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he began reciting this surah to the people. The mushrikeen, they were so overpowered by the awe of Quran, that when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went into prostration, all these people, the mushrikeen, they also went into prostration. But this going into prostration was an exception. Normally, what would they do? Normally, they would laugh. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would say the verses of Quran, what would they do? They would normally laugh. And not only laugh, but they would play music to disturb Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in the Quran, Allah says, وَأَنْتُمْ صَامِدُونَ, that whilst you are indulged in futile play. Allah calls this futile play. Something Allah has condemned, how can it be permissible to listen to? Ibn al-Qayyim rahmatullahi alayhi, regarding this ayat, he says that these people would play music to disturb others from Quran. He says that this music is such a thing that it makes a person less able to listen to Quran, and not only listen to Quran, but even ponder over the Quran. Those people who are becoming hafiz of the Quran, one of the most deadliest things for these people is listening to music. Look how Ibn al-Qayyim says. He says that this, when a person begins listening to music, he becomes less able in reading the Quran, and not only reading the Quran, but pondering over the Quran. How can a person who listens to music ponder and become an alim of Quran and hadith and what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba radiallahu anhu have got to say regarding the deen? A person who is listening to music, if he is not able to even read the Quran, how can he ever become a hafiz of the Quran? Brothers, this is something very, very important to remember. That our children who are becoming hafiz, who are becoming alim, it is very important for our parents and guardians to make sure that our children are away from this music, especially when they are becoming a hafiz of the Quran, or especially when they are becoming an alim of the Quran. Moving on to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, لَيَكُونَنَّ مِنْ أُمَّتِي أَقْوَامٌ يَسْتَحِلُّونَ الْحِرَى وَالْحَرِيرَى وَالْخَمْرَ وَالْمَعَازِفِ. That a time is going to come that a group from my nation, from my ummah, they will appear and they will begin trying their best to make fornication, the wearing of silk, alcohol, and musical instruments, i.e. music. They will try their best, they will try their utmost to make these things lawful. Today we see many people who say alcohol is lawful. We see many people, many groups around the world, that if you ask them, they don't find anything wrong with music, no musical instruments. Now, another interpretation of this hadith that the muhaddithin say is that they will not come straight out and say that these things are lawful. Rather, the muhaddithin, Allahu Akbar, they explain the hadith very, very beautifully, and they say that these things will become so widespread. These things will become so widespread that it will look as if these things are permissible in Islam. Allahu Akbar, if we look today, how much fornication is being carried out through our streets? Through England, through Pakistan, through Bangladesh, you just look and you will see how much fornication and zina is going on. You don't need to go far, just look at the colleges and universities. You don't even need to go this far, just look at your own internet. Look at the porn sites. Millions and billions of porn sites, all day in one laptop, just for our youngsters. Look at the alcohol that is being consumed by only our Muslims. Only our Muslims, if we look at how much they are consuming, Allahu Akbar, a person, he can come to a conclusion and say that, oh yes, it looks as if this is permissible in Islam. And then the music, every house, every room, every street, every shop, every street you go, music everywhere. Look at how true the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Music in the streets, music in the homes, is not as bad as music in the masjid. This ummah has gone to such a low level that today we are walking into the masjids and we are listening to all types of music. We listen to jungle music, rap music, love songs, romantic songs. We listen to everything, all in the form of an innocent ringtone. But our masjids, they're not as bad as when you are sitting in the haram of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you hear music going off. Again, all in the form of innocent ringtones. Again, if you look in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wallahi, I swear by Allah, if you go in front of the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the very person who made this impermissible, in front of his grave, you will see ringtones going off. All playing all sorts of music. Filth, abuse, talking about murder, talking about sexual intercourse, talking about being each other, talking about filth, all in front of the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is not something that I myself have seen. Many people are a witness to this, that they have heard ringtones, ridiculous ringtones going off in front of the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar, in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says the time in my ummah will come in which the people, they will witness people being deformed into apes, people being deformed into pigs. They will be rained upon by stones and they will be swallowed by the ground. A person that was sitting there, he said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when will this happen? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at his answer, Allahu Akbar, he says, that when songstresses and musical instruments, when they become widespread, you will see things like this happening. The ulama, the muhaddithin, they've interpreted the hadith and they've said that it will not happen literally. The deformation of pigs and into apes, this will not happen literally. Rather, it will be the attributes and characteristics of humans turning into pigs. Those people who go to the nightclubs, you will see, wallahi, that the attributes and the characteristics of those people in there, they have deformed into the characteristics of pigs and apes, which is shamelessness. This is the hallmark of pigs. A hallmark of pigs, shamelessness. Friday night, Saturday night, walk around the streets, town centers, near the nightclubs, and we can see a hallmark of pigs and apes, which is shamelessness amongst the people. Why? All because of this music. All because of this music, these people, it has turned their characteristics and attributes into the characteristics and attributes of pigs and apes. Like I promised at the beginning, that inshallah through the course of the bayan will be looking at the lives of some people who have involved themselves into this music and how much fun they are having in their lives. You know, if you look at statistics, we'll see that the pop stars, singers, music artists, they are fifth in the top 10. They are fifth in the top 10 professions with high rates of drug abuse, depression, alcohol abuse. Either before the concerts, after the concerts, trying to sort of calm their nerves down. If these people were so happy, if this thing that they were doing was so good, why go through the depression? Why go through drug abuse, alcohol abuse? You know, a study that was carried out by one of the universities, it said that pop stars and song artists, these people are more likely to die because of mental illnesses than normal general people. And not only these people, but also those people who follow these people. Let me just give you a small example of this. The Sunday Times, it gave a small article after the famous pop star Michael Jackson, he had passed away. They said that after he had passed away, 12 die-hard Michael Jackson fans, they had committed suicide. And you know what makes it worse? One of these 12 was a Russian who, after hearing about the death of Michael Jackson, what he had done was he had slit his wrists. But wallahi, you know, the thing to listen to is what he said to the paramedics. They run to him trying to save him. When they run to try to save his life, he said, no, please, don't save me, let me be with him. Allahu Akbar. These are the type of people that we are following today. These are the type of people that we are living around today. That they are giving their lives for pop stars. They're giving their lives for song artists. There was a time when people were giving their lives for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There was a time when people were giving their lives for their creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today we are giving our lives for song artists and for pop stars. How low has the Muslim ummah come to? If we look, we all know the famous song artist, Elton John. Very, very famous song artist, pianoist, songwriter. In 1992, Elton John, this guy battled depression, bulimia, and also drug abuse. We all know of Robbie Williams. In 2006, this guy had to go around, he had to stop all his tours around the world for 6 months. Why? Because this guy was going through depression. He was going through, you know, the article states that he was going through episodes again and again of depression. Sheryl Crow, depression again, chronic depression. The article states that it is chronic depression, and still today she is going through, she is on antidepressants. We all know of Britney Spears. Again, depression, drug abuse, alcohol abuse. And you know the thing that makes her so unique is that she is going through a multiple personality disorder. You know the thing that she is doing music, if that music was so good, if what she is so good, if what she is doing is so good, if it's so soothing, if it's so exciting, if it is so calming, why is this woman going through a multiple personality disorder? A multiple personality disorder is when one minute you want to be like a certain person, the next minute you want to be like a certain person, the next minute you want to be like another person. But she is not happy with her own self. We have millions and billions of people following this woman, looking up to this woman, thinking that Allah, she must have a beautiful and a very, very peaceful life. But she is going through something which is called multiple personality disorder. If what she is doing is so good, then why is she going through this one? Let me answer the question for you. You think you're going to break the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you're not going to be broken? You think you can anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of everything? You think you can anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stay pleased yourself? You think you're gonna shun the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah is gonna keep? Never. That person who breaks the laws of Allah, he will be broken. That person who leaves the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that person, he will be also left by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The verse that I had recited in the beginning, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَسْتَرِي لَهُوَ الْحَدِيثِ لِيُذِلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَيَتَّخِذَهَا هُزْوًا أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. In this verse, I'd like to draw your attention towards one specific part of this verse. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, he has mentioned various different types of punishments. Adabun shadeed, adabun aleem, adabun muqeen, very, very severe punishments. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says adabun muheen, a disgraceful punishment. Why is this punishment going to be disgraceful? The reason is because these people, they have broken the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gain fame. These people are going around pumping shoes in their cars. Why? Just to gain fame. They are breaking the laws, they are angering Allah, they are shunning the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all for fame. In this dunya and on the day of Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give these people such a punishment that it is going to disgrace these people. Why? Because they tried to gain fame through something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prevented them from. Something Allah made impermissible, these people, they went towards it. Why? Only to gain fame. Now Allah is going to disgrace these people. That's what these people are going through. My brothers, these people are going through disgrace. Allah is disgracing them. Allah is showing to the ummah that these people are nothing. Without the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a person is nothing. Breaking the laws of Allah, Allah is going to break you. Leaving the laws of Allah, when Allah leaves you, brothers, you don't have anything left. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding, true understanding of deen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength and ability to refrain from such a thing. I just want to end my speech there.